Hi, I'm not real. It's just an example of trying BTL. But in an alternative universe, I've got a mustache.
I know that the main problem with almost all AI avatar services is their high cost. At the same time, you don't always get a decent result. Sometimes it can be even frightening.
Or you. I just wanted to show off my new hairstyle. It's good, right? No, huh? Come on.
Exactly. I spent over a week experimenting to find the optimal workflow that would deliver a decent result while being as affordable as possible, ideally even free, and it seems to me that I found it. You can assess it yourself, as you've just seen the result. We will use the well-known tool LivePortrait, which provides very good results and works on low-performance PC, but important to note that you still need a GPU. However, its main issue is that only animates the face and a bit of the head. Head movements without corresponding body movements can look very unsettling and quite unnatural. Nevertheless, we can address this problem with a relatively simple and quite, I suppose, easy solution. I know that there are other tools like Hallo and SadTalker. However, Hallo is very inefficient. After 30 minutes of use, my 3090 Ti produced this result.
Hi, my name is Lisa, and I'm not real. I was created by Marat, and you can do the same for free using mainly open source tools.
Of course, it might be something wrong with settings and might be improved, but still, the main problem is inefficient. It takes about 30 minutes with my actual top-level GPU, 3090 Ti, so it's not usable and scalable for other users. As for the SadTalker, installing it to the latest version of WebUI is almost impossible due to countless dependency conflicts, which took me almost an hour to deal with before I gave up. Of course, SadTalker might be installed, but at the same time, it's not provides the good results, and it's quite outdated and not supported by developers. To start working with LivePortrait, we need to generate an image for our avatar. You can do it in any image generator you like, it's up to you. I used this prompt to create a sufficiently detailed face in Focus UI. Then, just using the same Focus UI, I extended the image to achieve the result you see now. In my opinion, it's quite good, and yes, I used the standard model. Next, once we have an image, since the LivePortrait cannot animate the body, we can animate it by yourself using various AI services to generate videos from images. Overall, this is free, and top two options are Clink AI and Luma AI. You can experiment with different prompts. I personally use this one for Luma and Clink, and the results work quite satisfactory for me. Since it's free, you might need to wait some more time, and it's not guaranteed that the result will meet your expectations. Therefore, you might want to send several requests and generate up to 10 videos to find the best one. And it could worth trying, probably use different accounts, but it's still up to you. But at the same time, it works only in Luma, because I waited about 15 minutes to get results. In the case of Clink, I got results after 3 days. And I'm serious, 3 days of waiting. So you could try, but I don't recommend it. Here, as you can see, the final result. It looks good, but there are two problems. First one is a watermark, at least it might be a problem for me. And the second, it's a length, only 5 seconds, but we can easily fix it in any editing software. Well, I recommend to use DaVinci Resolve, even free version is okay. So let's add our file to DaVinci Resolve. First thing first, we need to delete this watermark. Go to our color page. And here we need to search patch replacer. There. Put your video on the timeline. And then go to Fusion page. Put patch replacer here. And let's hide the watermark. Region shape should be rectangle. It's more convenient. And let's make it a bit smaller. And just position your patch to hide the watermark. Well, that looks great. Okay, now let's copy this file once again, and here press right button and change clip speed. Then just use reverse speed, and now we've got 5 seconds of our video. which in a cycle, in the loop. And it's not noticeable, but we make the video longer. Let's make it a bit more longer by copy this file once again. This one, the first one. And here we go, 15 seconds of our video is ready. And now we can animate it. To animate the video, we need to live portrait. If you don't have one, you can easily install it on your PC by following to the link under this video to LivePortrait official repository. And here you can find one-click installer. Just download this file. Then you need just press this button here to download the executable file and run the script to install it to your local machine. That's it. After installation, just run LivePortrait Windows folder and then just run bat file, run Windows human. And follow the link below. But most likely, the web browser will open automatically. Now that everything is set up, the next step is creating the driving video. This part is where things get both more interesting and more challenging. First, you can do this by yourself, by recording a video with your smartphone camera, where you can just dictate the text. This video will then be used for creating your animation. Alternatively, you can find a free services that will animate based on audio. While such animations might not look great, they are sufficient for driving purposes. For example, SadTalker overall is a great alternative for these purposes. Here you can see several examples of how SadTalker works. I could say it's not so great, but it's sufficient for animations with LivePortrait. And of course, it's free and open source. It's very hard to install, to my mind, at least in automatic, so you can use it Hugging Face Spaces. It works for free. In my opinion, the best result comes from dictating the text yourself. You can simply add movement without additional voiceover, using the existing sound. And your lip-syncing skills from TikTok might come in handy. Another option is to send the recorded audio to 11 Labs, which allows you to change the voice while maintaining the timing. 11 Labs is a paid service, which gives you about 10 minutes for free in every month. But there are also another alternative is Open Voice, which you can install it by yourself, because it's video already quite complicated. But I decided to record it video by myself with voiceover and will try to modify the voice using 11 Labs. So this is my video. The quality is not so important. The main problem with animation and your head movement. They shouldn't be too strong. An angle should be about 15 degrees. Also important is the first frame. On the first frame, your face should be neutral, without any expression. It's important for further animation quality. Now we can finally create animation. Here on the left, we should choose source video. And choose your video here. On the right, we should choose driving video. It will be me, in my case. And here are several parameters. And you can freely experiment with them, but to my experience, the base one, the standard one, works pretty well. And there might be a problem with preview of this video, but it's okay. You don't need to worry about it at all. So, animation region, we should choose all, and let it be expression friendly. And then just press animate button. After 1 minute, we've got our animated video. And let's download this file by pressing this button here. And let's see what we've got.
Hi, I'm not real. It's just an example of driving video. But in an alternative universe, I've got a mustache.
I definitely should work with my expressions. But these kind of artistic skills should be acquired quite easily with practice. But of course, there is a problem with the voice. There is still my voice. So we need to complete so-called transgender transition. For this purpose, I use 11 Labs. But Open Voice is also a great option. To change the voice, we should extract the audio from the video. So once again, use DaVinci Resolve for this purpose. Import media. My file is already here. Put it on a timeline. Press I for endpoint in O for outpoint, and let's export this file as an audio, audio only. And this should be, let it be MP3 format with a lower bitrate, about 128. Let it be this one. It doesn't matter. And add to QI. Then open 11 labs. Let's authenticate here. And here we should choose audio. Choose any voice you like. There are several options. Let it be Allura, social media. Here are some settings. Well, let it be less similarity and less stability. Why not? And press generate speech. And finally, we can download this file and add it to our timeline to get the final results. To switch off this in-out point, press Option X for macOS and Control X for Windows. And here our final result.
Hi, I'm Not Real is just an example while trying BTO. But in an alternative universe, I'd get a mustache.
Well, to my mind, this is really solid result. And yes, you could say that it's not so easy and quite complicated. There are a lot of steps. But the main purpose of this video was show you what is actually possible to do with partially free or absolutely free open source instruments. And it definitely so difficult and complicated only in the beginning. After you doing this several times, it will be much easier and straightforward.